Come on. Now for the top story tonight, reaction. Joining us from his headquarters here in New York City is Donald Trump. So after some reflection, after your victory last night, who do you think is your main competition right now among Republicans?
I would say all of them, Bill. I have no idea. Just keep chugging. Go forward. I think we have some really good positions, and I'm just going to use those positions. Strong military, take care of our vets, border control, security, generally speaking, now that we have the ISIS situation. Ever since Paris, it changed a lot, Bill, and it became outside big league security, and that was important. I think Obamacare is a very big issue. I see it. We're going to repeal it and replace it with something much better and much less expensive. And we have a lot of different things we're going to do.
All right. But South Carolina, every state is different. You know that. And South Carolina, it looks to be a battle between you and Cruz for, number one, the evangelical vote, which you won in New Hampshire. And number two, right, the committed conservative vote. So we just saw the ad where your guy was saying that he's an establishment, whatever he may be. So don't you consider Cruz to be your main competitor in South Carolina?
Well, he may be. I mean, he may be, but I really view them all. I mean, look how fast things can happen. I thought Marco would be there, and Marco had a bad debate. We have a big debate coming up on Saturday night. We'll see how it goes. So far, I've liked the debating. It's worked out well for me. But, you know, I watched that, and it was a pretty unpleasant situation
to watch.
Yeah,
so that could happen to you on Saturday. It could happen to anybody.
No, it's not going to happen to me.
Couldn't happen to you?
A lot of things, well.
Okay.
I hope not.
All right.
A lot of things. Hey, Bill, a lot of things can happen.
That's for sure. You said this morning on some other program that nobody really watches that Hillary Clinton is evil.
Which one?
I can't remember, but now you're on the big forum. You said this morning that Hillary Clinton is evil. What does that mean?
Well, they asked me, one word. I never liked the one word comparisons or analogies, but they asked me one word for various people. And she's got, there's a tendency, if you look at the job she did as Secretary of State and the destruction that she's caused, I don't know what it is. The word evil came to mind. The decisions that they made on so many different fronts as Secretary of State were absolutely insane. And I thought,
isn't that
the word evil.
All right, you invited Hillary Clinton to your wedding.
You could have.
Did you invite? You
could
invited
have said,
her to your
well,
wedding.
I mean,
you don't invite
I
evil
invited
people
you to my
to
wedding,
wedding.
Also, you know.
Yeah, but I have.
I invited you to my wedding.
I mean,
also.
Evil applies
well,
to me.
That's right.
But Hillary Clinton.
I got along with everybody.
But
hey,
why
Bill,
would? But
I was
I'm
business,
curious about this. Inept, I could see. You're saying that her tenure as Secretary of State really wasn't good for the country, but that's more of an ineptitude than. Evil is evil.
Okay,
is somebody...
it's inept. I could have used inept. I could have used inept.
But that's
you
in your
use
mind,
evil
though,
too,
you know?
Frankly, because
it's in your mind
at a certain
that she
point,
might be
you know what you. At a certain point, you say to yourself, "What's going on over here? How do you make so many bad decisions?" You look at what's going on in the Middle East right now. You look at the decisions made by her and President Obama. Whether you call it evil or inept, I really don't care. But a lot of bad things have happened, and a lot of death has taken place.
You don't really think she's evil, though. You don't think Mrs. Clinton's evil.
Well, let's just keep it in abeyance. Let's see what happens.
All right. Bernie Sanders, how do you assess the senator? I mean, is he a threat to the country, or do you find him amusing? How do you assess him?
I think he'd be easy to beat. Now, you never really know, but when people start figuring out that their tax bill is going to be 95%, I would think that that far outweighs the fact that he wants to give everything away. Somebody's going to pay for it, and you know he's going to pay for it, you and me and most other people. So when that bill gets down and they start talking about a 95% tax bill, I think he loses big league. I'm frankly shocked that a socialist, maybe beyond socialist, maybe communist, who the hell knows, but I'm shocked that a socialist is beating Hillary Clinton so easily. I mean, we'll see what happens, but I'm very surprised by it. I think in the end he won't make it, but we'll see what happens.
Do you believe that Bernie Sanders thinks that he can get the stuff that he says through Congress? Because I gave you a hard time about immigration. You're never going to be able to deport 12 million people. That's impossible. And I told you that.
Yes, I will.
No,
all
you
right.
won't.
Okay,
but we'll go back to
time
that.
Time will tell.
All right. Do you think that Bernie Sanders believes what he says, that he's going to run up another $19 trillion debt and nothing's going to happen? I mean,
what? Look, he was a very ineffective senator for years. I mean, he hasn't done anything as a senator. All of a sudden, he's going to totally change the country around? I don't think so. No, I don't think he believes he can get this through Congress. I don't think he even thinks he has a chance, but I think it sounds great for an election for his purposes.
So you think it's a vanity run? You think it's a vanity run?
No, I think that he does not believe he can get it through Congress. You'd have to ask him that question. He does not believe he can get it through Congress. I fully believe that.
Were you invited to the Sharpton Bernie Sanders breakfast in Harlem today? Did they ask you to come?
I'm devastated. I'm devastated that I was not invited. I would have loved to have been there.
I would have loved to have been there. Wouldn't you like to? Yeah, because there's not a chance in hell, quote Madeleine Albright, that Sharpton's going to support Sanders. I mean, he's a Hillary.
Well, look,
he's a Hillary guy.
I know Al Sharpton better than I know you. And I've dealt with him for years and years and years. And, you know, when he's not political, he says, oh, I love Donald Trump. I love Donald Trump. But I will say, in fact, he came up to my office not so long ago to apologize because on his show, which is now off the air, which is a fortunate thing, he called me a racist. And he literally came up to my office and he apologized to me, which, by the way, I thought was very nice. So I know Al, you know, Al is just doing his thing, Bill. He does his thing. We all do our thing. He was doing his thing, and he continues to do it.
All right.